There will be a full blue moon in Pisces on August 31st, 2012 at 6:59 a.m. Pacific Daylight Time for those of us in California, or 1:59 p.m. Universal Time for everyone else. Don't expect the moon to be the color blue, just recognize it as the folk term that people use when there are two full moons in the same month. During the new moon, we reset our emotions and intentions for the upcoming month. During the full moon, we evaluate and measure the activity that helps us to meet our goals. During the Pisces full moon, humanity's role between the divine and the animal kingdom is highlighted. This is a time when the circle of life is vivid in your daily task, as the circle of the full moon echoes wholeness, completion, and achievement through the ingenious Mercury-ruled Virgo and the boundless creativity of Neptune-ruled Pisces. With the sun in Virgo and the moon in Pisces, Pluto in Capricorn helps to harmonize the scrutinizing focus of Virgo to shift passionate Piscean hopes and dreams into a menagerie of manifestation. Neptune's vast multidimensional vision plays a very important role in manifesting the hope and faith that help humanity to prosper during the darker moments in history. In astrophysics, the planet Neptune is a gas giant that is the eighth planet from the sun. Discovered in 1846 by French mathematician Herbon Le Verrier, Neptune is made up mostly of hydrogen, helium, ice, water, ammonia, and methane. Neptune shares more similarities with Uranus than it does with the other gas giants, Saturn and Jupiter. Neptune takes approximately 165 years to orbit the Sun once, has 12 moons, and spends almost 14 years in each zodiac constellation of the ecliptic. Neptune was the first planet to be discovered using the mathematics of astrophysics instead of simple observation through a telescope. Like Uranus, Neptune has very faint rings. These planetary rings are rarely seen in photos. In mythology, Neptune is the god of the sea that is also associated with or known as the Olympian god Poseidon, ruler of Atlantis. Neptune can deny or provide safe passage on the sea for mariners. He carries a trident that controls all bodies of water, creates horses, storms, and generates earthquakes. The Pisces sign symbolizes two fishes swimming in opposite direction that are tied to one another at the tail. This represents the duality of the watery, mutable, flowing, and adaptable Pisces nature. One fish is assertive, positive, and swimming upstream. Conversely, the other fish is receptive, negative or magnetic, and swimming downstream. There are many myths that explain the origins of the Pisces symbol. All accounts start with Typhon attacking Mount Olympus, causing the Olympian gods to run for their lives. Typhon was the last of the children to be born to Tartarus in Gaia and was known as the father of all monsters. Typhon's human upper half was said to reach the stars, and he supposedly had over 100 dragon heads. Breath mint, anyone? His bottom half was a gigantic viper coil that could reach the top of his head. After the Olympians defeated the Titans led by Atlas, Gaia sent Typhon to destroy the Olympians. All Olympians changed form to escape. Venus escaped with her child, Cupid, to the Euphrates. In one account, the love goddess and her child turned into the two fish and swam off with the band tying their tails together so they wouldn't lose each other or become separated. In another account, two fish showed up and carried mother and son to safety. This accounts for the many myths of cultures around the Euphrates, where gods in the form of fish appear with enlightenment for civilization. Jupiter did manage to defeat Typhon, and to this day, Typhon is said to be under Mount Etna. There is another account where Venus and Cupid were simply led to safety by two fishes. These fishes were placed among the heavens for helping Venus and Cupid to escape. Such myths about the assistance of the fishes can be associated with some civilizations around the Euphrates that will not eat fish. Pisces is a mutable water sign that occupies the 12th house of the zodiac ecliptic. In modern astrology, Pisces is associated with or ruled by the planet Neptune, also known as Poseidon. However, traditionally, Pisces is co-ruled by Jupiter, along with the zodiac sign of Sagittarius. The Pisces persona has two modes of interfacing with the world. One is kind, sweet, unassuming, charitable, and nurturing. The more shadowy persona of Pisces can be passively manipulative and dishonest, not to mention extremely moody. The dark side of Piscean nature is the selfish escape artist that will tell you a disco lie to get what they want and escape responsibility. Pisces tend to be one fish or the other, and the more integrated and evolved Pisces are a combination of both characters in polar mutable equilibrium. The fact that Pisces is associated with a sky god and a sea god should hint at their incredible capacity for divine acts of heroism, courage, and strength. While the Piscean spirit can mostly be identified with the playfulness of the dolphin, be careful not to upset your Pisces. An angry or unbalanced Pisces may lead to mortal combat with an intellect that is as fast and furious as a school of piranha or as gangsta as a shark attack. We all know about the sweet Pisces that likes to avoid conflict, but don't get it twisted. There is a tank top wearing version of Pisces that has no problem telling you what they think and what you can do to yourself. Be careful not to wade too deep in the waters if you can't handle the waves. Whether you are talking about the thunderbolts of Jupiter or the tsunamis and earthquakes of Neptune, don't make yourself a victim in a bad shark movie. I'm just saying. Pisces is considered the old soul of the zodiac as they occupy the 12th and final house. At this stage, the seeker has experienced all of the houses and passes beyond the veil, leaping off of the wheel of life into Nirvana, Amenti, Shangri-La, or what most people refer to as heaven. The wise, strong, eternal, and faithful Pisces soul may choose to leap into the cleansing fire of rebirth and reemerge in the first house of the zodiac as a bodhisattva. By choosing to walk the path of the zodiac until all of humanity is worthy of cosmic reunification, bodhisattvas are said to travel upon the earth with Christ consciousness. Generally, bodhisattvas provide knowledge and healing throughout the plane of physical reality until all souls are ready to enter the kingdom of light that is unity consciousness. Virgo, Capricorn, and Taurus. Fasten your seatbelts and get ready to jump into hyperspeed. With the sun in Virgo and the moon in Pisces, you are taking full advantage of the spike in energy from the ingress of the Virgo sun. Mercury in Virgo can try to oppose Neptune in Pisces, but the trident of Neptune is acting like a cosmic tuning fork, harmonizing you with Pluto in Capricorn. This cosmic dance is giving you the power to access innovative vision in all of your projects. The hexahedron earth element reminds you that you are the electromagnetic verb of action, organization, and communication. You now have the opportunity to transcend adversity by harmonizing with the other qualities of earth and water. You are a vehicle of success, drag racing on the futuristic road barreling towards tomorrow. Virgo's scrutiny is now harnessed and guided as a laser beam of ingenuity and adaptability. Now is the time to shift your dreams upon the cosmic strings of the ether and manifest the courage and drive necessary to polarize the eddy currents in the river of life that sync up with your wishes. Business ventures, confidence, and project management only serve to magnify the material motion of your magnetic mindfulness. Your frequency and speed increases as you recognize that you can materially mechanize everything in your environment to count on as a success. The high-definition screen of Virgo's cosmic navigation system allows you to grasp the fine print of all the details, while Pisces' expanded consciousness allows you to integrate that into the larger road in front of you. The abacus of accountability is being shaken to the rhythm of Saturn-ruled Capricorn's fierce climb to the top of the mountain of consolidation, success, and completion. Each solar stride successfully executed with unshakable determination and perseverance shoot you to the scintillating summit of success. You are an imperishable circumpolar star whose wisdom and warm light nurtures and guides each seeker out of the darkness of chaos into the anchoring solarium of knowledge, wisdom, and humility. You know that nature is the ultimate reality, and your awareness and experience of Mother Earth's beauty is the photosynthesis that triggers the flowering on the purest path to your enlightenment. Libra, Aquarius, and Gemini. With Jupiter in Gemini and Saturn in Libra, you benefit from expanding your horizons and diversifying the activity in your life to avoid your galactic enemies of boredom and routine. You are very active but long for a Neptunian escape from your regiment of intellectual obligations into the dynamic and spontaneous world of challenge and creativity. Your intellectually airy focus is as sharp as its metal equivalent in Chinese astrology, sculpting out endless possibilities that are attached to your immeasurable imagination. With the fiery full moon in Aries coming up at the end of September, you have turned on the ignition of your jet propulsion system and spark plug the combustion of action and reaction at home and at work. This is the time to invest in getting your pet projects done because you are taxiing down the runway, getting prepared for another supersonic flight of action and creativity on the platform of communication. As the moon waxes and wanes through the zodiac, expect that there will be some hard-hitting reality checks on the state of emotions in your environment. This is a small preview of the next shocking square dance that will take place when the moon and the sun square off with Uranus. There will be a breakthrough for you, provided that you are present in your emotions as an observer with the intent of understanding the conversation between your head and your heart. Remember to channel mutable Gemini's stereoscopic perceptions to adapt to uncertainty and adversity while using fixed Aquarian higher octave awareness to prevent overreaction. The balanced focus of Cardinal Libra will create solutions to all challenges, clear the pathway to your bliss, and reinforce the cosmic connection between communication and manifestation. You are the multiverse's personal DJ, and your healing tones and words of wisdom puts everyone's mind at ease, filling their hearts with the rhythms of completion and promise. You are the superconductor for the orchestra of life. Flowing, dynamic, measured, and intuitive. Your message of mind over matter transcends all channels of the electromagnetic spectrum of light and sound with a message of affirmation. Love is the triumph of imagination over intelligence. Scorpio, Pisces, and Cancer. With the forces of the earth and water spiraling through the cosmic square dance of Pluto and Uranus, you are the ocean wave of high tidal change that everyone is wishing for. You are the living example of how mankind's inner conflict could be resolved through the imagination rather than the intellect. Your motivation is so high that you may not be sure exactly how you want to invest your time and energy. You don't have to choose between duty and fun, as your Neptunian insight combined with the power of the Mermaiden of Cups makes your macro manifestations universally applicable at work, at play, and in love. You are surfing on a tidal wave of romance that brings refreshing mists of optimism, faith, and hope to the shores of indifference, revitalizing the withering landscapes of defeat with the promise of euphoric heights that reach beyond the Earth's gravity well. Be careful not to make any promises that you cannot keep. Instead, focus on sharing your intentions while visualizing what you want for yourself and your loved ones so that those around you know how to support your watery voyages. Keep art therapy at the top of your list because it is sharpening your mental ice chisel of creativity, thus allowing you to sculpt the light that emanates from your heart and soul into corporeal reality. Your love and imagination is the thunderbolt of Jupiter and the trident of Neptune combined into a lightning rod of healing and compassion. This unconditional, eternal love can turn back any tornado of tedium that threatens to destroy your kingdom of happiness, joy, and recreation. Your icosahedron channels of cleansing are evidence that water can be as accommodating as the morning mist among the flowers or as catastrophic as a tsunami. So don't worry about those who might mistake your kindness for weakness. Instead, focus on the fact that water has memory and recall how much beauty that you create in this world when you step away from the drama and focus on being a creative force instead of a receptive one. Remember that one Pisces fish swims downstream, representing Venus, and the other's fish swims upstream, representing the higher octave of your creative force influenced by Neptune. Time to call on the fierce barracuda strength that is the Pisces fish swimming upstream.
Believe that no matter how fierce the currents are, you are an unstoppable force that will not yield until you reach the shores of your objectives. So remember to go with the instincts behind what you feel and ride the waves with wonder and abandon. Sagittarius, Aries, and Leo, you don't need to prepare because you are always ready for action. With the solar maximum, the solar eclipses, and the fierce T-squares of Uranus being channeled through the fire sign continuum, you are the galactic class starship ready to shift the world to a higher frequency. As activities and projects pop up in your personal and private life, you recognize that you have reached full tilt on anxiety and have now surrendered the illusion of total control and replaced it with collaborative control. Building hope in your community through action, warmth, humor, and biting truth, you are a multidimensional time traveler intent on placing the world upright on its axis to get a more aerodynamic spin. Your fiery passion is expanding through the strength and sage wisdom of Jupiter-ruled Sagittarius, giving you the power to motivate others to take expansive actions and co-create better environments. The vector equilibrium that is the strength and courage of Leo gives you the torque that you need to reach the escape velocity necessary to silence your critics and accomplish your goals with jovial fanfare. Enthusiastic Emperor Aries will accept nothing less than an all-out effort to break past the sound barrier of survival and make the quantum leap to the cosmic cornucopia of abundance and rejuvenation. Like the three-pronged trident of Neptune, all three modes of fire mirror humanity, earth, and heaven, reminding us all that everything we think and do is symbiotically connected to all events here on earth. The tetrahedronic tethers of intuitive brilliance and tenacity are proof that the heart has a brain within itself that leads back to the divine spark of creation. Remember to take a step back, cool your jets, and allow the rest of the cosmos to catch up, because the speed of your thoughts may be the one thing in the universe faster than the speed of light. With the deer upholding the pillars of the four directions of fire, earth, air, and water, the jaguar walks upon the emission lines of clarity, skill, and quality. These qualities harmonize with the unlimited capacity of the Mercury-ruled Virgo sun, with the tones of strength and balance vibrating the reminder that, as above, so below. From simplicity to infinity, the energy of the galactic tones and the jaguar bring artistic order and joy to our daily tasks so that we can whistle while we work. The day of the full moon, or Lamat, will be the multiplying star energy across the cosmos. Harmony and balance are the compulsion for everyone intent on increasing the abundance of love ushered in under the Pisces full moon. Those who are intent on creating a better world through collective meditation, organization, and assessment over disdain and judgment will soul train with the water dragon as this angel of the east dances through every meridian and chakra in your body and across the world. Pisces is the ultimate example of the servers and saviors found in the 12 labors of Hercules and in mythology in general. In the 11th labor of Hercules, the hero learns how to be of service with the help of Aquarius, while in the 12th labor, he learns to be a savior. Not the savior that we connect to religious beliefs or institutions, but the savior that we become when we choose to redeem and save ourselves, and said experience is shared on the grid of collective consciousness. The window into the eyes of the Pisces soul represents our own free will transmuted into divine purpose. Only through love can we surf these magnetic waves of hope, faith, and grace. The golden chalice can represent the missing link of instinct that humanity loses when it chooses to stick with left brain science and exclude all other experiences. Pisces plays a role as the child of God and the higher-minded link to humanity. The three prongs of Neptune's trident can represent many things: mind, body, and spirit, birth, life, and death, past, present, and future. The Pisces' mutable association with Neptune serves as a reminder of the complexity of consciousness and the various facets of understanding that bend through the prism of awareness. One fish can represent the active physical love and beauty of Venus, and the other can represent the primordial, unexplainable vastness of light that is love through Cupid. Together, like Pisces, they are the balance of the soul and the ego. Perhaps each day we struggle to keep our positive and negative forces in balance, we increase our ability to lead with our soul over our egos. Perhaps the two fish represent the ultimate balance of humanity's collective reunification into unity consciousness. Perhaps as the mind becomes more illuminated with love, it becomes easier for the soul to navigate seamlessly from the seat of the third eye chakra vortex. As we collectively transcend service and become saviors, perhaps the mind's job is to mediate between the spirit and the redeemed personality so that we may enrich and serve our world better. Perhaps integrating adversarial archetypes with the shadow side of our own personality empowers us to heal and save ourselves, and through that process, we save the world. As we save ourselves and build rainbow bridges towards global coherence, we summon the alpha waves of shift that carry humanity towards apotheosis and cosmic unification. Saving ourselves while we save others help to create the dynamic New Age structure that has begun to replace the autocratic systems that no longer serve humanity holistically. The new moon egg that is the rebirth of Virgo will start our rapid descent into the fall season with plenty of shocks so that you don't miss the purpose of the show. Pisces is an omniscient eye that seeks to free mankind from the three delusions that keep humanity on the wheel of life: lust, hatred, and ignorance. The final lesson of the labor of humanity is that which can be destroyed by the truth should be. Destroying artificial reality and saving yourself along with your cosmic brothers and sisters advances us one step deeper into the age of Aquarius.